I think part of the reason that perhaps secular relativism seems to be taking hold more and more in our society is that people seem to have lack of an understanding of Christ's kingship, of just the transcendence of God. For instance, I think there's more people now that think themselves to be spiritual rather than religious.
Right, that you see that a lot. I'm spiritual, but I'm not religious. Mm-hmm. I think part of it is because we know if it's true religion, it's going to put demands upon you. You know, you're going to have to follow the commandments, for example, if you if you're going to really be religious. So I think a lot of people, it's sort of an escape. You know, they realize that we're spiritual creatures, and they realize they need a spirituality of some kind. But they don't want a spirituality that has any binding effect on them, that they have to change their lifestyle or that there may be something in their life that they have to change. And I think a lot of people who maybe don't profess atheism, but they live as if there was no God.
Mm-hmm.
And so you ask them, no, I believe, but you know, there's no indication that they're following God, and they're following themselves or what they believe God is. So it's kind of a practical atheism as opposed to a, you know, spiritual atheism.
This interview was an excerpt from the February Pro-Life podcast, which is sponsored by Lincoln Right to Life and Nebraska Right to Life.
We ask that you subscribe to our YouTube channel, where the entire interview with Bishop Conley will be published in mid-February. And we also ask that you continue to pray for our pro-life leaders. They help to guide us in protecting life from conception to natural death.